Freud and his followers. Concurrently, in a curious juxtaposition, the psychoanalytic theories and therapeutic practices developed by the Vienna-trained physician Sigmund Freud and his many disciples beginning early in the 20th century and enduring for many decades were undermining the traditional view of human nature as essentially rational. Freudian theory made reason secondary. For Freud, the unconscious and its often socially unacceptable irrational motives and desires, particularly the sexual and aggressive, were the driving force underlying much of human behavior and mental illness. Making the unconscious conscious became the therapeutic goal of clinicians working within this framework. Freud proposed that much of what humans feel, think, and do is outside awareness, self-defensive in its motivations, and unconsciously determined. Much of it also reflects conflicts grounded in early childhood that play out in complex patterns of seemingly paradoxical behaviors and symptoms. His followers, the ego psychologists, emphasized the importance of the higher order functions and cognitive processes, e.g., competence, motivation, self-regulatory abilities, as well as the individual psychological defense mechanisms. They also shifted their focus to the roles of interpersonal relations and of secure attachment in mental health and adaptive functioning, and they pioneered the analysis of these processes in a clinical setting.